So this is my video about walking sticks, but also something else. So on the left you see also a regular umbrella, which is quite sturdy and quite a big one, but still is a lot weaker than the next umbrella. This is more of a umbrella that we use for a wedding, so very robust. And next to it is, they call it an unbreakable umbrella. This one is even more robust, stronger tip, and they have a different approach. They have a polypropylene shaft instead of the steel ones of the other ones. Next to it is a very lightweight, adjustable walking stick. So it's aluminium but very light, and you can adjust it to fit a very small size, almost like this. So to store it, for example. Next to it, it's a walking stick of light aluminium, the orange one, orange red one, and it carries some survival items like a compass, window breaker on the that tip here, and it has a pointy bit, so the knob that hits the ground is more for rough terrain, so it's quite pointy. Also, it could carry a saw or something like that. Next to it, you see the same principle, but then more robust. Aluminium, far thicker, far heavier, without all the added functionality such as a compass and all the other stuff. Next to it you see more of a shepherd-like walking stick. Petterdale is also examining it here, with a hook in it. Another hook design you see next to it, it's just more of a old axe-inspired design. Both are completely plastic. And next to it you see a full aluminium walking stick, so a very elegant type of walking stick. And next to that you see a steel tube with a narrow, small diameter layer, and it has some limited prying ability, so there's a very small pry bar at the top that you can also take out. Next to it you see cold steel. So these two are also CS. So you see here the walkabout, so simple walking stick, and next to it is African walking stick. And on the end, you see something completely different than a walking stick. This is they call this a fitness mace bell thing. So it's far too heavy, 4 kilograms, but it could be used for training, for example. You see it here. And also the other walking sticks could also double up as training tools, of course. So just get some cardiovascular exercise, but also some strength and fitness and flexibility. Of course, the main theme is, except the mace bell here, which is a fitness tool. All these other tools could be used as a walking stick to a degree. Of course, if you use the umbrella, you have the drawback that it will bend over all the force that you could exert on it, but light work could help. Could still hold up. The same will be with this collapsible walking stick. If you are too heavy, you will have troubles with it. This umbrella here could be the best of both worlds. So it could give you some cover against rain, but could also double up as a walking stick. The benefit of the straighter edges that you can see here is that you can also use it a little bit to lean on. For example, if you want to sit, but there's nowhere to sit on. Those could help, of course, as well. Now I will show you some of the features of each individual stick or the likes. Let's start with the mace bell. As compared to all the others, except this one, which is not a walking stick. This might be the second heaviest. This is just a more of a show-off gentleman type of walking stick. Very elegant tip, as you can see, and then it tapers up a little bit. Also very nice work on the handle. The benefit for such a design is that you can, the other one you had to hold as a knob, but this you can like more of a pistol grip. So it's easier for the hand, you have some more positions you can position it in. And also the benefit is you can lean on top of it if needed. So that's a benefit that you will also see with some of the other walking sticks of similar design. For example, this one. And also the benefit is you can lean on top of it if needed.
So that's a benefit that you will also see with some of the other walking sticks of similar design. For example, this one, also CS series walking sticks. As you can see, they tried to resemble a little bit of the axe head. In the past also, they had walking sticks with, with real axes on top of them, so if needed, they could chop a little bit. But this, of course, is completely blunt, but it still has some of the benefits. Also, this is not a sharp, acute tip. Very nice design. It also resembles it a little bit more of an axe handle, so it's more of an elliptical shape, so to say. It is even better to lean upon because you have more surface and more flatter area, especially because this side is also elongated a little bit. I really like how this feels in the hand. It's like a little bit of a hammer or an axe handle. This is more of a traditional traditional shepherd like stick, so it has more of a curl instead of a flattened area. The flattened area I like a little bit more because this has some drawbacks in how it feels. You will slip a little bit to these sides, whereas since it's more flattened out, this will help a lot. The benefit, however, of this one is it's very elegant, as you can see. It's everywhere as the same width. Also, the benefit that you have a little bit of a hook if you need to, for example, climb and you have to pull somewhere on a branch or something. You have quite a good chance that this will stick if needed. Also, a little bit of additional grip here, a little bit additional grip here on the tip, and also again here, which I like a lot. Also, this one can be made to the size that you want. This is from the United series. Also, a very nice, light, good walking stick. And this walking stick, this is perfect if you need a walking stick for a situation that you you don't know if you need it, just for light work. Also very easy to collapse. This is weighing almost nothing. This is by far the lightest walking stick, and as I told you, it's very easy to put to a different size. As you can see here, for example, just it is not, but you can also collapse it to an extremely small size, as I will show you here. So it can be collapsed to about half the size that it originally had. And then you can just get it back to the size that you need. Also, for example, if you take this with you and you have an injury, you can still lean upon it, but also use it for your children because you can easily make it to any size that you need. So this is just your traditional, because you can easily make it to any size that you need. So this is just your traditional type of umbrella. This is the lightest of the three that you see here. Also, you see that the core is still steel, but can be bendable, but still quite robust. It's an old timer, also quite an acute tip, which can be beneficial if you're walking off-road, but less so on the streets, because you don't have the rubber tips that most of those walking sticks do have. And it will bend over if you press too hard on it. The benefit of this is that you have a little bit of the hook, it's like in the shepherd style walking stick. So that gives you a little bit more grip, but as I mentioned, it will still give you a little bit of movement. It's leather, so it's quite anti-slip. And also you could use this as a little bit as a hook, which can help, of course. Then the next umbrella.